This is a POE IP camera, and this other one is a non-POE IP camera. There is POE stated on the nameplate of this camera, which is what tells you that it is a POE IP camera. The non-POE IP camera does not have POE indicated on its nameplate, and by that you know that it is a non-POE IP camera. I will in this video demonstrate the practical difference between POE IP cameras and non-POE IP cameras using these two cameras here. When you take the terminals of a POE IP camera, through the Ethernet port, you can both supply power to the camera and also take video from that same Ethernet port of the POE IP camera. The power terminals on POE IP cameras are added alternative means by which you can supply power to the camera in a case where you don't have a POE switch to be used in your setup. But once you have a POE switch through which you can power up the camera through the camera's Ethernet port, the power terminal would have to be left idle. So this Ethernet cable connected to the camera would both supply power to the camera and also take video from the camera. So even if no connection is made to the power terminal, the camera is still completely connected. All I have to do is to plug this end of the Ethernet cable to a POE switch and the camera will be functional. Before I really plug the cameras to the switch, let me explain the situation about non-POE IP cameras. The Ethernet ports on non-POE IP cameras are not enabled to supply power into the camera, and so the power terminal is the only means by which you can supply power into a non-POE IP camera. So when I plug the Ethernet cable into this, it is not a complete connection. I still require power to be fed into the camera through this power terminal on the camera, unlike a POE IP camera. So let me now demonstrate what I just explained. So I'll connect the POE camera into the POE switch. You can see that power is present in the camera, even though no external power connections have been made apart from the Ethernet cable that has been plugged into the camera. When I connect the non-POE IP camera to the switch through the Ethernet cable, you can even observe on the POE switch that there is no activity on the connection to the switch. The LED on the switch is not flashing. So I'll use this adapter to put power into the camera through the power port and plug this end into a power outlet. Please observe the face of the camera as I turn on power to the power adapter I connected to the camera. You would have observed that the infrared lights on the camera flash on as I turned on power to the camera. And you can also see activity on the point where I connected the non-POE switch on the network switch as well. The use of the power adapter is what has enabled power to be sent into the non-POE IP camera. A check at the connections again, you can see that the non-POE IP camera is using an external power source in addition to the video connection to function, whilst the POE camera takes both the video and the power through the Ethernet ports on the camera. You can see both cameras fully functional, as you can see the video outputs on the screen that is in the background. Please leave your comments and questions about this video in the comment section. I'll respond appropriately to all your comments. Please remember to subscribe to the channel and also give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.